Welcome to my home studio tour. A while ago I did a video on the live room, if you can call it so, of this studio, which has to be my favorite room in this place. But for the last 3 years this has been the heart of the whole studio, and it's where I spend most of my time, whether it is recording, studying guitar, writing new songs, or even hanging out. This also is the room where I film most of my videos, and today I want to show you my setup and what I use right now when mixing or writing songs. It's something that will change quite soon because the whole place is going through a renovation right now and everything will be built from scratch, but today I want to show my current setup because I want to have something dedicated to the first control room I ever built. So let's get started. So this is the heart of the studio. It's where I spend most of my time in this place, and it's also where all my gear, the little gear I have right now, is mounted and ready to get used. The desk itself is just a DIY build because it's a simple desk on which I mounted my very own handmade rack self. At the heart of this simple setup is the Presonus Studio 192. This is my audio interface for the past 2 years, and I can say that I am quite pleased with it. 2 years ago, when I was researching about an upgrade on my audio interface, I had the Focusrite 18i8 at the time. I ended up choosing the Presonus audio interface because I had started using the Studio One, which is also a Presonus product, which I actually use right now, and this audio interface had a great integration with the system I was using. Another reason I chose it was that I read a lot of good stuff about its converters, and in some blind tests that I listened to, you couldn't really tell it apart from much more expensive units. So I went for it. To have the ability to record more channels from the live room, I have added the Digimax D8 ADAT preamp, and I can say that this combo has worked quite well on the jobs I've done here. On this desk there are also the MIDI controllers I use right now, although I don't use them very much. It's an M-Audio KeyStation 61, which I have for whenever I want to play something on the piano, and also an Ovation Launchpad, which I use with my secondary DAW, which is Ableton Live, for all my live looping performances. The studio monitors I've used since I've built this place are the Evaudio SC205s. I really love their sound and have been great for me, but I have one point that I want to get across. These monitors, to perform their best and give you the best results, really need a well-treated place. When I first got in here, I really didn't have that much acoustic treatment in this place, and I can say that I really heard what these monitors are capable of when I first put bass traps on the front corners of the room. Their sound totally changed, which is absolutely normal because they are backported and their positioning is a bit tricky. I tried quite a lot of setups to find the place they are right now, but I've been quite happy with them ever since I put those bass traps and all the other acoustic panels which I've built myself. Actually, I don't know if these monitors will be in my new setup because I'm considering upgrading to something else, but I don't know yet. I have to audition the speakers I'm considering and see if they really provide me with something better than what I've got right now. So we'll see. On a final note about my monitoring setup, I also use 2 other pair of speakers which are really nothing to write home about. They are just a simple set of cheap computer speakers on which I check the final stages of my mixes, and also a pair of old PA speakers which are there for the same reason. The PA speakers sound absolutely terrible, but they're really good when you want to hear how your mixes translate because they are quite big in comparison to my main speakers. On the right side of the desk is the guitar corner, and this is where all the guitar equipment and the guitars live, excluding the amps, which are in the live room, of course, because they are quite big and loud to be played in here. The purpose of this place was to have everything readily available for myself, as well as anybody that gets in here, so that you can grab a guitar and go whenever you have a great idea, or whenever you want to record something. This is something that will be designed in the new control room as well, because it is something that is essential to me and my workflow as a guitarist and a musician. On the other side of the desk is the place where I keep all my pedals. Actually, the pedals that I don't use on a daily basis, but I want to have as options whenever I'm recording. this space will be completely redesigned in the new control room because I want to make a bigger one in order to fit any additions that will come over the years, because I have to face it, I will always buy guitar pedals. If anyone has an idea about how to build the new pedal space, let me know. And actually, that's it for my studio tour. I just remembered that I didn't really talk about what I used to make these videos with. My main camera right now is a Sony A6300 with a Sigma 16mm lens. I use the Godox SL60 as my key light, as well as some other smaller LED lights for hair and rim lighting and all those stuff. And I edit all my videos on DaVinci Resolve. Let's get back. The only thing I forgot to mention is that I'm working on a Windows-based machine, but that's something that is a matter of personal preference and what I'm used to. I expect that a lot of this stuff will change in the next 3 months, but I want to make this video because I've spent countless hours in this room over the past 3 years, and I have to say that it really feels like home at this point, and I will be a bit sad to see it go. Anyway, that's it for this video, thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.